You have never looked in your partner's eyes for 60 seconds. You haven't looked in the mirror for 60 seconds. You haven't told yourself and looked in the mirror and told yourself you love yourself. You would feel that you were sinning or you were selfish if you even did that. Now think about that. How does that sound for dysfunction? Meanwhile, this person, I want to spend the rest of my life with you, but you can't look them in the eyes. Couples will never ever know each other, even if they've been married for 50 years. They compromise their lives. Yes or no? They compromise their lives. So when we go to do this now, it doesn't matter. When you look into the eyes of this person, it's going to go back and forth. You're going to see them for who they are, really are, and you're going to see what you really are. And trust me, there's no horror story here. Oh my God, I wouldn't want to see that. Oh no, you're going to see what's going on. You will see sadness. You will see sadness. You will not see evil. There is no evil inside of you. That's just something they force-fed into your brain. And when you're looking inside each other's eyes, those are the windows of your soul. So it doesn't matter. You could be doing this with someone you met now, just now. And guess what you'll have? The most beautiful connection. You know, I don't believe it or not. You're going to feel awkward at the beginning. And then guess what? Within a couple of minutes, we're only going to go for 10 minutes, but within 2 to 3 minutes, you're going to feel more connected to that person, most of you. Some of you will never be connected to anyone because you're not connected to yourself. But most of you will have more of a connection to that person than you had with your lover. Yeah. This is the real thing. That out there, I don't know what you call that out there, husband and wife stuff. That stuff is awful. Tell me it's all cracked up to you. Man, woman, husband, wife. No. Two spirit beings coming together for the greatest adventure in the universe. That's all it is. That's what it should be. But first, until you have a relationship with yourself, can't have a relationship with someone else. And the relationship you have with someone else is a mirror of the relationship you have with yourself. So what I want you to do is just connect to the lion heart breath. Does everybody know about the lion heart breath? 6 seconds in, 7 seconds out. And then I want you to connect. When you put your arms on either side of them, you will feel their breathing go in and out. And then you will connect to their breathing. Trust me, there's nothing sexual about this. So connect to their breathing. Put a slight smile on your face. There goes the nervousness. Look in their eyes. Okay? So if you've got an itch, please itch it. If you feel there's a bit of urine in there, go now before we start. Because your subconscious doesn't want you to fall through with this. You do know that, right? And you do know why you've never ever looked at your lover's eyes for more than 60 seconds? Because What if they see the truth, but the truth is they're only going to see beauty because you've been living a lie. You've been living a lie your whole life that you're not beautiful. Watch. Watch this. Watch what happens. So we're going to connect with each other's breathing, and you're going to remain, nobody's allowed to talk or make noise or scratch. So if you're anything itchy, seriously, get yourself as comfortable as possible, okay? And then just try to settle in. Just know that your back is going to ache, your neck is going to ache, okay? You're going to feel like you need to sneeze. That's your subconscious going, this is uncharted territory. And remember something about the subconscious. The subconscious will not allow you to have something unless you put passion, purpose into it, and you want it. If you don't really want it, it's not going to get to you, and you're going to have to really want it. When a couple, you want to know what happens? You know those ugly divorces? If you can get a couple to come together and do the couple's connection for 33 days, for 10 minutes, and then talk 10 minutes after they do it, they either fall totally in love like they've never been in their life. Oh yeah, there was fireworks the first 6 months to a year, right? And then that dwindles away. That's not the real love affair. Doing the couple's connection will give you the real love affair of a couple, because you will rise in spirit. If you want to get reconnected to your daughter, your son, your mother, your father, you do this. See what happens. I want to talk to you. Well, can we do the couple's connection for 10 minutes? I don't know. No, let's just do it. It's not going to hurt anything. Then when we're done, you can do whatever you want. After the couple's connection, it's this. There's nothing to do. I apologize. I forgot who you were and I was. I forgot who you were and I am. I am what I am. I lost myself. But guess what? I guarantee you that most of you, if you're married right now or you have a partner, that you're not even connected. You're connected different ways, but you're not connected like this. I guarantee you, you're going to find a connection if you've never done this before, and you may not even know this person, or you know them very lightly, and you'll have a deeper connection on a level than you've had with your husband or your wife. Do this for 33 days, and guess what happens? Oh yeah, not everybody stays together, but they come up, they leave each other as friends, not as enemies. But I will tell you right now, not nine out of 10 times, but 99 out of 100 times, when they do the couple's connection, they reconnect deeper than they ever connected in their whole life. And they realize the fights they've been having were programmed into them so that they will never, ever come together properly. 5,000 years ago, religion and government, if you go into my library and go watch I Am Woman, they said the only last thing we need to do is have man and woman declare war on each other. I already told you, what do you want to feed? A higher self or a lower self? So let's do this. And if something goes into your mind while you're doing this, just let it float by. It's just a river. The mind's just a river. Do people throw things into the river? Somebody else is throwing garbage into the river. And if you see a turd, just go, oh, turd. If you see a beautiful flower, let it stop and hold it. And just bring that in. Okay? You got it? Mm-hmm. Any questions? Like, oh my God, what am I doing here? Okay, all right. So get comfortable. Okay, everyone, there's no talking. There's no talking. Got another word. You see how hard it is not to talk? Remember something. Let's not talk, let's feel. Understand, you should be coming closer. You should be able to put your arms at least on the person.
Right, so you did it. That was 10 minutes. Now, stay with your partner, but let's make a circle and just keep this open. This area here, keep this open, but let's make a circle around. That was 10 minutes. Actually, it was 11 minutes. I went 1 minute over because I needed to torture you.
I didn't feel at least a bit tortured. I felt absolutely wrapped in warmth and, I mean, I've always noticed this energy. So this just sort of brought home my love for her, and the experience of it for me was very beautiful. I had I kept getting runs of goosebumps and runs of heat that would go up and down in my body, and I guess I'd express it almost a feeling of I was in the arms of love. I had come home. That's what it was. The experience was like for me.
What do you think would happen if people were to do that with their partner for 33 nights and then sit down and talk for 10 minutes? What do you think that would do? I know, but how important do you think that would be for people to do that?
Well, it would be
life-changing. Yeah, well, how important do you think it would be for a mother to do that, to bridge the gap with a child that she feels she's floating away from, or with a sister or a brother or just someone. Mm-hmm. Have you ever done it with your partner?
Yes, we did. Yes, we did.
And how many days did you make?
Oh, we only did it once.
See? And I'll tell you why. Not because they don't love each other, but because the subconscious said no. One day of that, that's it. Because your subconscious, the more you get excited about something, the less it wants it. Did you ever notice that? Mm-hmm. Look at how many opportunities you have missed out on. You usually just end up doing the same thing, don't you? If you want different, you got to do different, you got to blow through that. What would you think would happen if you did it for 33 days with your partner?
I believe our relationship would sprout entirely new.
He would actually know you. He doesn't know you. You actually don't know him. We hide from each other because we think there's stuff that we have to hide, because if he found out, you wouldn't want to be with me. Isn't it great that we have relationships out of fear? Shalu?
Well, for me, I just observed that in the past, you know, like you were saying, it feels uncomfortable, like you're something or other feels like, okay, I gotta hold it evil. And but looking at Lori, one eye, there was deep sadness. It was very, very deep sadness. And I just kept repeating.
But let's be honest, we've known Lori for a while, and we know that there's some deep sadness in there that she doesn't want to go near.
And she kept blinking a lot. It was like she didn't want me to see the sadness. There was a lot of blinking. And it was sadness, and then it was almost like she was trying to protect herself. And I just kept saying, you can trust, you're safe. You can trust, it's okay. And that was this eye, and that's the eye that the tear rolled out of. And when I looked at the other eye, it was just an observer. There was nothing. It was just, I'm just going to sit back and watch what the world has to bring.
Dual personalities.
That's very true.
Yes. Yeah. Dual personalities. You have to speak louder.
I said, and I have to get to know both of these people in me. It's not fair.
No, you don't want to know either one of them. You want to find the authentic one that's behind the curtain.
I think I have found her.
Do you?
But I realize, I know what she's saying. The sadness. The injured child still clings. Mm-hmm. It brings to mind the time that, actually, this was really poignant for me when I think her. Maybe girl in BC that did the it's not Alicia, it doesn't matter. Anyway, she did the mirror work, and I remember she started to cry, and I identified immediately what she was crying about. I said, she's afraid to let go of the little person she was. She's afraid to let go of that. And then later on, when they were asking, what did you feel, she said, I know that I'm letting go of this person that I've hung and clung to for years. And it brings me some sadness. I'm afraid to let her go. So that for me was really a very poignant moment, because I felt it in her. I could see it in her.
Well, you're not actually scared to let her go. You're scared that maybe if you let her go and become herself, she may not be safe anymore.
Yeah. I can see that. I can see that.
That would be you.
Yeah, keep her safe.
That would be you. Oh, you're doing so good, Lori. You know that.
Thank you.
You're like a little rocket ship.
The little engine that could.
Yeah. Anything else, Shalu? What about yourself?
Well, that's where it came full circle, because as I'm saying this to her, and because I couldn't catch up with her breathing, like, it was very shallow.
Yeah, it was coming.
And so, you know, I breathe with her, but then I'm still breathing and she's exhaling, and I'm like, okay.
You're relaxed.
So I'm like, okay, we're not going to worry about the breathing, but as I'm just observing, I'm like, everything I'm saying to her, I need it for I am safe and I can smile.
Very powerful. All right, thank you. Is there anything else you want to say?
No.
I think that was probably the only thing I missed in recounting what I was experiencing is I was focused mostly on this eye, same thing, and when I would try to look on at the other eye, my mind wanted to draw back to this eye. I would see more emotion in that eye. I could see more, I could identify more. And when I would back out a bit and look at both, it would mess with my concentration. I wanted to focus on that eye. And I kept thinking, so powerful, so beautiful. She's so powerful, so beautiful. And that's what I kept feeling in my, experiencing in my,
Thank you.
Thank you.
Would you like to come? Speak loud enough, okay? That everybody can hear you though.
I just kept seeing you like brave and strong, but you have this barrier and you're scared to break it. It made me cry and I shed one tear and you just kept crying and I'm trying to smile and, you know, read what you were feeling and why you were crying. And I'm like, she's scared. She's scared and she's not used to it. And she's trying to get used to being a woman. And you are beautiful and you are, I don't even know. It was wild how much I was seeing of that. But I just kept trying to push on to you that you are strong and you are beautiful and you are bold and you need to let everyone see that. Because you are, and you can see that. But you can see that there was this shell that's holding you in. And it wants to break free, but you're scared to let it go. Am I reading that right?
You are absolutely on the money, okay? On the money. She's just trying to process it right now. You have to give her a moment. Do you see you now? Do you see how wonderful and powerful you are? Did you know that you were actually stroking her back? Did you know that? With one hand, you were stroking her back. Do you know what kind of unbelievable spirit you are? That was phenomenal. Just watching it. You were so in tune that you were bringing her into proper vibration with you. If you didn't do that, she wouldn't have locked in. You are going to be an amazing therapist if you ever decide to, and if you're not, then you're just an amazing woman. Not just, but you can have whatever you want. I'm telling you. What did you feel about yourself?
I was trying to project the same things onto me. I am bold, I am beautiful, I am strong, and I have that shell as well that I am trying to crack open and let myself shine through. I want that. I want so much for you, like you deserve, and I want the same for myself.
Winnie, speak loud.
Okay.
This is day four.
I felt her comforting me and it helped me complete the couple's connection and I felt supported from her and
saying, I love you.
Oh,
I love you. I love you. And I just kept repeating love, love, love back to me and to you. And that's very cool that you felt that.
I did. I felt it.
Such a very cool. I felt that.
Beautiful. Thank you, guys. So, you know, when we did name that disease, I got TikTok back yesterday. They took it away from us because of name that disease.
Apparently, it's misinformation.
Misinformation. So, we're never going to be able to, on TikTok, we're going to have to keep everything superficial. None. You know what you're allowed on TikTok is to berate and harass and to demean people. That's what you're allowed to do on TikTok. So now they cut me off for another week. Hi, girls. How are you? Good. All right.